today.
Ooh.
The thinking customer will see right away the best deals this side of the pond.
Anybody there? Open up.
What's the fuss? The bathhouse is closed.
Need to talk to the owner. I know he's here.
I'm not sure that matters, as he's terribly busy.
Busy? With what?
Entertaining important guests.
In that case, tell him there's another one at the door. Geralt of Rivia. And I'm not leaving till I see him.
Very well. I shall try. Please wait.
Sigi Reuven cordially invites you to join him. I'm happy. The meeting is in the baths. We will pass through the dressing room so you can leave your clothes.
Let's go.
You may disrobe here. Your equipment will be safe. Splendid! Sigi Reuven awaits in the next room.
Hi, Whitehair. Nice bun you have.
You were right. He doesn't blush.
And Junior cut off his hand, then ordered them to shove it up the corpse's arse. And then he sent the body back.
He's more like a horse.
This is a simple matter. Poor son got an invite, chose not to...
Easy, Cleaver.
Orson Junior's a dead man. I'll have my scribe send you a notice.
You don't have a scribe. And we'll eliminate Junior when, and only when, all of us say aye.
Reuven, your guest.
Why the fuck you let him in here? Because I want to talk to him. This is Geralt of Rivia.
Good to see you again.
As always, I'm out of the swiving loop. Who the fuck are you?
Think I'll let your host introduce me.
He's a witcher. The very one who first foiled an attempt on Foltest's life, and then killed that monarch.
Allegedly. But I didn't kill Foltest. And hello to you too, Dijkstra, Reuven, whatever they call you these days.
Last we met, Geralt thrashed me silly and crushed my ankle. I really wonder what he's got in store this time.
Got intruders. Someone just snuck inside the bathhouse. Several men.
What the fuck's he on about? Plowing fortune teller?
Assassins!
Bloody hell. I fucking knew it.
Any weapons tucked away?
Just a few.
First ever party with my prick hanging out. Ah!
You'll regret that provocation!
Oh, son, dude.
Come on.
Keep it together!
Good work, gents. Terribly sorry for that incident. My security failed. I'll get to the bottom of who, why, and how.
They were horse and scum. That's the bottom of who and how right there.
Don't start that again. Especially not in front of our guest.
Who pranced in right before they attacked. Coincidence? Why do I doubt it?
Let's give him a chance to explain.
I'm looking for Horson Jr.
Interesting.
What do you want with him?
Junior's gonna help me find someone.
Horson's not helped a soul in all his miserable life.
I'll ask him nicely.
See, Cleaver? Perhaps if you'd not called Junior an uncle fucker and asked him nicely, he'd have showed up today.
Gentlemen, you out of your fucking minds? A chat session? Horson's out to get us, and he'll succeed, eventually. We've got to kill him first. So by all means, you sit here, soak, fart, and watch the bubbles rise, while I send my boys to Horson's hidey holes. They'll make some noise, flush the bugger out. And you, geriatric, or whatever your ploughing name is, wanna find Horson? Find me first.
Any clue on Junior's whereabouts? Be grateful for any lead.
Siggy?
It's worth a try. Geralt's got a knack for finding people, and he's discreet, a value in itself.
Leave you to it, then.
I'll look in on you tomorrow, Francis. Finish our talk.
So how about we get dressed?
Sure, sure. Then we'll talk. In private. Right mess that was. Never thought I'd be glad to see the man responsible for my taking frequent baths.
If you're any cleaner for it, gotta say it was worth breaking your ankle.
It healed poorly. Can you believe it? I must soak it in hot water at least 6 times a day now. Failing that, it bloody pounds like the bells of Beauclair at dawn.
Sorry to hear that.
You're sorry? Well, consider it resolved, then. Now, mind showing some added compassion could mean a miraculous recovery to me.
Listen, Reuven. No, Dijkstra. Just not in the mood for your code names, passwords, and other bullshit. I'm here on specific business. If you want to listen, listen. If not, I'd rather you spared me your wit and threw me out now.
What's the harm? Talk.
Think Cleaver will find Horson?
He might. He might not, but he'll burn down half the city trying. What waste. Leave him to it, I say. Work alone.
Any ideas?
Junior's got areas of the city where he's strong. Penetrate them, look around. But be discreet. None of this speed and fury and swinging your steel cock about.
Makes sense to ask around, I guess. Junior might be in hiding, but he's got to be collecting income. Couldn't afford to cut himself off.
Gambling. That's his big earner. Junior controls the largest casino in town. I'll never forget. Hierarch Hemelfart raised all kinds of hallowed hell there once. Bugger bet and lost his ruby ring. Then there's the arena in the city's bowels. Betting scheme generates near as much as the casino. They're always looking for hired muscle there. Suppose you could always search Horson's house. Though I doubt you'll find him there. Maybe some clue, though.
Where's Junior's casino?
Near the Temple Watch Towers. Horson's got nought to do with a casino officially, so care for what you say. Try not to arouse any suspicions.
Arena sounds promising. Where's that?
Sewers beneath Gildorf, but you'll have to enter through the bits. Endure the stench of poverty on the way. Now, Junior loves a good fight. Wager he'd give a lot to see a real Witcher in action.
Mentioned Horson's got a house. Where is it?
Solid townhouse on Temple Isle, just on the other side of the bridge. Wouldn't wager me knickers on finding him there. Junior's not that stupid.
See if I can't find Horson at the casino or the arena. Might talk to Cleaver as well, though.
Do what you will. Just be cautious. Horson's expecting payback, I've no doubt.
Thanks for your help, Dijkstra.
Just go, Witcher. And if you can't find the slimy bastard, come and see me. I know him well. Might figure something out.
You in contact with Radovid?
See, you're as witty as ever. No, I'm not in contact with him. I prefer it remain that way.
Never quite forgave you for conspiring with Philippa Eilhart?
Radovid doesn't forgive. Not anything. Not anyone. And especially not the sorceress of the lodge.
Philippa Eilhart. Had any news?
Just good.
Meaning?
After Radovid popped her eyes out, she disappeared without a trace. If I've any luck, she's finally eating dirt.
Thought you two were close.
We were, until Philippa sent assassins after me.
From Master Spy to Master Criminal. Interesting progression.
Why? Truth be told, they're awfully similar. Both about maintaining a net of informers, being tough in negotiations, bribing officials, the occasional assassination. Same old shit.
Yeah. Except you used to do that in the name of some ideal. And now?
Now I've decided I've slaved enough for ideals. It's time I worked for myself. And thus far, it's been going rather well.
Listen, Dandelion's missing. Any idea what might have happened to him?
Same thing that happens to anyone who steps on Junior's toes.
Meaning?
He's surrounded by splendid virgins who ply him with sparkling wine and pastries stuffed with nightingales' tongues. Come, Geralt, what do you think's happened to him? I reckon he's at the bottom of the pontar, trussed up with the strings of his own mandolin.
Loot.
Far as I'm concerned, he might as well be rotting down there with a goddamn trombone.
You wouldn't happen to have a bone to pick with Dandelion, would you?
Course I do.
You serious?
Dead serious. Dandelion published a sonnet recently. Second stanza, the shit uses paired couplets instead of an inserted rhyme. Surely you understand how deeply offended the poetry lover in me was. The bastard shan't get away with it.
I was being serious.
As am I when I say I have exactly no time to worry about your gigolo boyfriend. Got me own problems. Problems you might be able to help me with. And if you did, why then I might be inclined to ask after Dandelion, establish what happened to him.
Maybe I can help. What do you need?
I'd rather show than tell. Picture's worth a thousand words and all that tripe. Ah, and you do realize, if you say anything about what you see here to anyone, it'll mean a razor between your ribs.
Figured as much.
Excellent. One last request. Oh, let's call it what it is. A command. Don't draw your sword unless I ask you to. So kind as to follow me. Not again.
Bart.
Bart, stop that. Now!
Bart! Bart! Bart, mate, Ziggy lose, Jonathan.
Beating your head against the wall won't change that.
Bart, but less thinky. But less thinky. But sadness.
Don't seem to have trouble communicating with the troll. Why'd you bring me down here?
Take note of that hole. We'll come back to it later. And see that door? Vault behind it, until recently filled with Novigrad crowns and countless other valuables.
But God! Then boom! Chorfun, go!
Translating into common, someone fucking made off with nearly 20 tons of my gold and all the lighter stuff. And you will help me get it back.
Fine. I'll help you.
You're not exactly bursting with enthusiasm.
Witcher mutations. They strip us of emotion. I'd be jumping for joy otherwise. All right. Ought to look around. But first, some questions.
I'm all ears.
Anyone see what happened?
Other than Bart? No. And the vault's location is known only to the treasure's co-owners. Well, and the thieves.
What about upstairs? Anything unusual happened in the bathhouse the day of the break-in?
No. Happen swears it was calm as ever. The usual customers, no incidents. Bloody bucolic.
How much was it all worth? Got an approximate idea?
Why the fuck do you care? Figuring your finder's fee. Don't get your hopes up.
Know you too well for that. Just prefer to know what I'm looking for.
3 crates of Nilfgaardian florins. A chest of emeralds, rubies and topazes, silver candlesticks and platters. I could go on.
Shiny Jorfun! Oh, God!
Take it the thieves got in through the hole behind you.
You're a regular fucking master sleuth. Any other brilliant deductions you want confirmed? The year, maybe? Bloody name of Redania's king?
No, but I am wondering, for instance, how that hole got there.
Hole no. Boom. Hole. But look, won't go. But look, no. Only sleep. Bad shrooms. Head falls.
Boom. Can you elaborate?
Like.
I'll elaborate. Explosion, big enough to blow that fucking hole in the wall, separating the vault from the sewers.
Gotten pretty good at communicating with this troll.
Lots of prior experience. Worked with idiots my whole life.
Bad mushrooms? What's that about?
Pops mold. The spores are highly toxic. One whiff and you're dead. Unless you're a troll, that is.
Yes. But... Bart, troll.
Not talking to you, dimwit. Where was I? Mold spores. They cover the walls of the sewers other side of the vault. Actually thought it was a good thing, you know? A bit of extra protection. Thieves found a way through it.
Bart, you see them?
Bart, through hole. Once see, boom, got what? Breathe. Shroom. Sleep go. Jorfun gone. Bad troll.
Now. Stiff upper lip.
Try to track down the thief yourself?
Of course. Hired this lummox Fonce, thick enough not to ask questions. We knocked back some pops antidote and entered the sewers. Soon after, I returned alone.
What happened?
Lad started belching something horrendous. I mean, burps with so much mass the walls shook. Told him, Fonce, stop. You're in the presence of a count. Well, former count, but still. And then he puked up. Up came most of the antidote. Lost his protection. Tried to pull him out,
Then I heard a bubbling. Something crawled out of the water. I value the lives of my men, I do. But I value my own even more. Dropped Fonce and ran like hell.
Mind describing this something that crawled out of the water?
No. Doesn't mean I can, though. Air in the sewer's thick with spores. Can hardly see a thing down there.
Must have noticed something. Was it...
No! Didn't notice a fucking thing. Didn't do a taxonomic field analysis either. I know it's an inconvenience to you, but I felt I should get the hell out of there as fast as I could.
Should look around the sewers. Got any more of that Pop's antidote?
Have a few vials left. Got the formula too. Disgusting swill, to be honest. But it'll save your life. Here.
Thanks.
You've naught to thank me for, literally. You're no good to me if you suffocate. Listen, I'll be upstairs if you need me. Sight of this empty vault's giving me an ulcer. Good luck to you.
Dandelion, what the hell have you gotten yourself into? Edges curled out. Something inside blew it wide open. Wall too. Bathhouse drain pipes seem to converge here. Pipes great. Explosion crumpled it like a piece of paper. And there's mortar on the bars. So it was in place at the time of the explosion. Blast tore it from the wall. No traces of magic. This was no spell. It was a bomb. Now why am I not finding pieces of it? Could be the curtain swept them away. Shouldn't go any further without taking that antidote. Cylinder, most likely. Runes etched in the bottom. It's warped, probably by the explosion. Bomb part. Must be. Smells like wyvern oil and caramel. That'd be it down here. Time to see Dijkstra. the minute.
I do. What do you want?
Done. Examined every nook of the sewers near your vault.
Well, learn anything?
Seems to me a bomb blew the wall open. Look.
Bottom of a silver cylinder, probably. Covered in runes. Interesting. Any idea what it contained?
Recognized some ingredients by their scent. Wyvern oil and sugar.
Sugar? Geralt, I'm in no mood for jests.
Nor am I. Just saying what I found. Bomb contained sugar.
Let's think. Sugar would react violently with sulfuric acid, but not so violently to cause an explosion.
Didn't know you were versed in alchemy.
Dabbled in it a bit while at Oxenford Academy. But this is no time to reminisce. You're to find my treasure, not write my biography. Know anything else about this bomb? Anything at all?
Drain pipes are only promising lead. We just need to know which pool it's connected to.
Yes. Appen keeps a record of guests. Should be able to tell us who used that pool the day of the break-in. You've not done badly.
Feel honored to be acknowledged.
Oh, that famous sarcasm. I missed it.
Really?
About as much as I'd miss a knife in me knickers. All right. You inspect the pools on the right, I'll take the ones on the left. Holler if you find anything.
Nothing here. Something floating on the surface. Oil, looks like. Silver lid. Matches the cylinder bottom I found in the sewer. Dijkstra, come here.
Got something?
Yeah. Bomb part.
Happen. Drain pool 4 and bring me the guest book. Chop chop.
Let's see what's on the bottom. Grate's been removed from the drain, meaning they flushed the bomb down here.
Happen. Who used this pool the day of the break-in?
Let me see. Bertolt Heinz, town councilman, Josef Vgfaq, brewer, and Margrave Henkel.
Henkel? That's impossible.
Impossible? Why?
Old Coot's been eating dirt since last winter. Couldn't have been here the day of the break-in.
He's dead? I'd not heard.
Not surprising. The Honourable Margrave croaked in a brothel, decked out in leather lingerie, so the family held a hush-hush funeral. But I have my sources.
Yeah, I saw him that fateful day, Mr. Reuven. I'm certain of it.
Did you speak to him? Get a good look at him?
No. He merely passed by on the way in.
So you didn't see Henkel. You saw an impersonator. Think for once. They scooped out your balls, not your brain. And you, Geralt, start looking into this.
Fine. Where should I start?
Henkel's home. Derelict townhouse south of the main square. You might happen on some trace of this scoundrel we're looking for there. Well, off with you.
Oh!
Silver cylinder. Bottom looks like what I found in the sewer. A letter. And a bottle. The wine from your birth year. It's absolutely excellent. Startling bouquet. You absolutely must try it. But afterwards, please place the bottle back where you found it. Your birth year. Could be dandelions. Or Ceres. 1245 to 1254. Satisfying click. In the next room over, I think. Secret room. Probably where Dandelion and his cohorts planned the heist. Instructions on how to build a bomb, signed by one Kalkstein. Sugar, and lumps of a substance dipped in wyvern oil. Potassium? Looks like they made the bomb here. Siri, Menge is following me. He has seized the treasure. He has Dandelion. You must flee. Footsteps. Not good. Stain. Wyvern oil. Didn't expect to see you here. Certainly not with Triss.
I decided we could use someone who knows a bit of magic. The runes on the bomb. I'm absolutely dying to know what they mean.
You dying to know too, Triss?
No, just here for the coin.
Ah, Marigold playing the cynical materialist. I love it. In truth, her ideals brought Triss here. She needs gold to save her colleagues. When I recover my treasure, I'll be in a position to help her. Simple as that. Speaking of which, and pardon my bouchlerois, have you found out who fucking nicked my gold?
Bothered Triss for nothing. No point examining the bomb.
Because?
Because I already know who nabbed your treasure. Commander of the Temple Guard, Caleb Menge.
Well, well, Marigold. Your coin stands to come with a side of revenge. Geralt, would you be kind enough to tell me what you've learned? I'm terribly curious.
What I've learned doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter? Yet you agreed to help me.
I am. Doesn't mean I have to confess everything.
I'll let your insolence fly this time, but only because His Honor the Margrave might indeed have something to do with the theft. Menge has been spending heaps of coin lately, though to my knowledge he shouldn't have a copper to his name.
So, what now?
From what I've heard, Menger spends his nights at the docks, witch hunter's quarters. Maybe pay him a visit. Ask where he's holding my gold for me.
Doubt Menger will admit anything willingly.
As do I. Lucky I hired a witcher and a sorceress who've been through so much together to get this done.
What's our past got to do with it?
A great deal. Lovers will jump into the abyss for one another. Suits my needs perfectly. Namely, it greatly increases your chances of getting out of the hunter's barracks alive. With my treasure.
In other words, you're using us.
Using you? Never! Merely making the most of your mutual bond. Well, lovebirds, I really must be going. Good luck.
Thought you'd correct him. Say that we, you know.
Dijkstra doesn't need to know about my love life.
Wise. I'd never choose his shoulder to cry on either. But we've strayed from our topic. Got a treasure to recover.
Triss, gotta tell you something. Dijkstra's gold, it's the last thing I care about.
Thought as much. This is about Ciri, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Menga's got Dandelion locked up somewhere, and Dandelion saw Ciri.
That changes everything. Listen, meet me at midnight by the Chapel of the Eternal Fire, east of the harbor. We'll figure out a way to get into the Hunter's Barracks together.
All right. See you then, and thanks.
Glad you're here. Listen, took a look at the building and it does not look good.
Mean it could use a bit of paint and spackle?
I mean, it's a damn fortress. High walls, guards at the gate, armed men everywhere. We could never sneak in, and fighting our way in won't work. Menga would have had plenty of time to escape.
What do you suggest?
Take these shackles. Put them on me.
Mind explaining what this is all about?
Think. Bring the hunters the vial Triss Marigold. They won't just open the gate for you. They're likely to let you present her to Menga personally.
No way. Too risky.
Dandelion's life's on the line. Ciri's too. No such thing as too risky.
Fine. Let's say they take the bait. What then? We go in, I put a sword to Menga's throat and ask him where Dandelion is?
Might not work. Menga's scum, but you have to admit, death doesn't scare him.
Always found that annoying in fanatics. So we gotta trick him into talking. Any ideas?
Maybe tell him you have information about the Lodge. Or about Philippa. Even better, he hates her most of all. You'll think of something.
Still got a bad feeling about this. But tough. Let's go.
Geralt, remember, I can take care of myself.
What are you talking about?
The hunters. They won't treat me like a lady, but I'll survive. Might hurt a bit, but... Ciri, she's what matters. Do what you need to do, no matter what happens.
Can't promise that.
I'm still asking you to, all right?
All right.
What do you want?
Here for my reward.
What the hell for?
For a witch. Recognize who I got? It's Triss Marigold.
Marigold? Come in then.
Well, well. Triss Marigold. Giving up drowners for sorceresses?
Pays better.
It's cause they do more harm. What's a drowner do? Pull the odd fisherman from his boat. But the witches, they murder kings, scheme, start wars.
Don't forget turning your cow's milk sour straight out of the udder.
You're done jesting, Marigold. For good. Put her in a cell.
Not so fast. I hand her over to Menga himself, or not at all.
You reckon we don't know what to do with this witch?
Let go, you bastard!
Vulgar tongue's got no place being in such a pretty mouth. I guess we'll have to rip it out.
Try to loosen it if I were you. Might learn something interesting.
For instance?
For instance, where Philippa Eilhart's hiding.
I'll get you for this, you...
Shut your gob, ginger whore! And you spit it out! Where's Eilhart?
Thought I made myself clear. I'll only talk to Menga.
Menga don't talk to the likes of you.
Well, then you be sure to tell him I came by. With my friend Marigold.
Fine, grab her and come with me. But be sure to stay right close.
Beware.
Oh!
For you know.
Here's where we split up. Go see Menga. Marigold will be next door.
You can't have her until I get...
You don't set the terms here. Dirk, you know what to do.
You won't get a word out of me. Not you, not him.
Oh, playing tough, eh? Just you wait. We'll take a fingernail or three. That ought to get you singing.
Do what you want.
Come on, witch. Show you the wonders a pair of pliers can work. You'd be surprised.
I believe I told you not to let anyone in.
Unless they had information concerning Philippa Eilhart. This witcher says he's got just that.
Anyone can climb that.
We'll start with your pinky nail. Nah, let's go for your ring finger. This little piggy went to market.
But it's not that easy to bring us Triss Marigold.
Is that who I hear? Very well. I'll go see her shortly. But first, let us talk. Sit. Sit. Have a drink, Witcher.
Sidarian.
A 1261 vintage, year of the massacre of Sintra.
Stop squirming! This little piggy went home!
Stop!
Kurt, please see why Miss Marigold squeals so convincingly. Perhaps she needs something. Hot irons, for instance.
Speaking of metal, this goblet's silver. Making sure I'm not a Doppler.
Ah, it's immediately apparent. A professional. I find that refreshing. But to answer your question, one can never be too careful. You'd be surprised how many come here turn to rancid jelly as soon as they grip the goblet.
Still haven't paid me for the witch, yet your hunters are already torturing her.
What of it?
You're damaging goods you haven't paid for yet.
This little piggy had roast beef. This little piggy had none.
Don't worry, you shan't leave empty-handed. I shall pay you twice the usual reward for Marigold.
Awfully generous. Why?
Well, you've turned in your lover. The emotional trauma it must entail. You deserve compensation.
Yeah, I've plowed Triss. But what does it matter if you're paying gold for her head?
Oh, yeah. Nearly forgot the mutations strip witches of feelings.
No. No more.
Be brave, dear. Just one more fingernail, and we'll move on to the other hand. This little piggy went wee, wee, wee. Ow! Bitch bit me.
Ah, oh, the bitch bites. Let's put a collar on her. Dimeritium ought to calm her down.
You surprise me, Geralt. Perhaps we can deal after all. So, you know something about Philippa, but I wager you won't share this information for free. What do you want in return?
It's simple. Free Dandelion.
A degenerate bard for information about Philippa. Tempting offer, I admit, but I must say no. You see, I've a magnificent execution planned for Dandelion in Oxenford. A breaking wheel, flaying alive, and so forth. It should work wonders for the mores of the academic youth and townsfolk.
When's this morally instructive spectacle due to take place?
When I issue the order, in person. Dandelion will remain in the dungeons beneath Temple Isle until then. So sorry I cannot be of help. Perhaps we can agree different terms. But first, let's see how Miss Marigold fares. It's grown suspiciously quiet in there. Come.
Say this. That was just a bit premature.
What do you mean?
Menga said Dandelion's locked up on Temple Isle, dungeon right under the temple. He was planning to execute him in Oxenfurt. Also said they'd only let Dandelion out of his cell once Menga gave the order, in person.
Shit! I'm sorry, Geralt. I should have thought it through, but when I saw him, I...
What's done is done.
He'd never have agreed to help us. Even if I...
I know. Let's not dwell on this. We should think about what to do next.
Dandelion's safe, for now. Though out of reach. We don't stand a chance of breaking him out. Temple Isle's impregnable. And Menga's not likely to order his transfer. Or anyone's for that matter.
Saw Menga burn a sheet of paper right before we came in here.
Could have been something on it that would have helped us. Too late now.
So there's no way you could recover the note?
Sadly, no. I'm a sorceress, not a miracle worker.
Let's search his corpse.
Right. Could find something that'll help us. Just his office key in his pockets. Here. Nothing under his belt. Wait, something sewn in the lining.
What is it?
The key to a vault. Here, give it to Dijkstra with my regards.
Could you revive him?
Maybe. If I actually practiced black magic. Haven't sunken that low just yet. Nothing but dead ends. We'll need to make do.
Menga's the only one who could have ordered Dandelion's release.
Yes. Or someone who looks exactly like him.
A Doppler?
Mm-hmm. Your old friend Dudu Biberveld impersonated the halfling merchant. Dandelion claimed he seemed more real than the original. So much so, Vivaldi gave him a loan of several thousand crowns without batting an eye.
Yeah, except Dudu's in hiding right now. Priscilla might know something, though.
Fingers crossed. Listen, there is one other thing I wanted to talk about, but not here, not now. Come by when you have a moment. I'd appreciate it. All right, we need to get out of here. This is where we split up. But first, let's burn this shack down.
Agreed. We've left too much evidence.
Yeah, but I also need to blow off some steam.
You there! Mr. Reuven wants a word!
Impatient old bastard.
What?
Nothing. Be there soon.
Who do I spy? Why, it's Geralt of Rivia.
Will you stop following me already?
I will, as soon as you tell me where my treasure is.
Me and Menga didn't see eye to eye.
How badly?
Badly.
I suppose that explains the smoke. My treasure's not in there, is it? Burning with the witch hunters.
Didn't see it anywhere, and 20 tons of gold is hard to miss.
You mean to say you've come to me empty-handed?
First off, you came to me. Second, I do have something in my hand. The key to a vault, founded on Menga.
A vault that I need to find on my own. You've not made things much easier for me. Give me that.
Spare me. I want my reward.
Geralt,
Do all you witches have such nerve?
What do you mean?
You lied to me.
What?
You knew from the start who robbed me, but you didn't deign to share that information with me.
How'd you find out?
I asked the questions here.
Not true. That was a statement. Come on, Dijkstra. This tough guy act doesn't work on me. We're both adults. Act like one.
Ah, Geralt. I should have you strangled, but I like you, you bastard.
I like you too. You count without a county. Now that we've professed our feelings for each other, how'd you figure it out?
Since from the start you were up to something. You didn't haggle about your pay. And then I heard from my sources that Margrave Henkel and Dandelion had rubbed elbows. Wasn't hard to connect the dots. And now, time to settle things.
That a threat?
Quite the contrary. You helped me, Witcher. So in spite of everything, you've earned your reward.
Don't bother. I know what happened to Dandelion.
Then take my coin. I always pay my debts, even to liars. And a final humble plea. Don't try to fool me again. Ever.
You!
I'm glad it's a state of mind.
Ugh, there's no fucking integrity in this world.
Dandelion, I know where he is.
Where?
Dungeons on Temple Isle.
That's not a nice jest.
No jest, sadly. But don't worry, we'll pull him out. Triss has an idea. All we gotta do is find Dudu.
So you must find Dudu in order to find Dandelion, with the aim of ultimately finding Ciri? Sounds like an awful lot of searching, but I do wish you luck.
Don't have a choice. I gotta meet Horson Jr. He might know something. Take care now.